This C# SMS Quick Start covers both inbound and outbound SMS. We're going to use the code from a guide found in the Twilio docs. You can follow along from the link down in the description. Your application makes a post request to Twilio, and Twilio sends a text message. It's that simple. We'll start in Visual Studio 2017 by creating a new ASP.NET web application targeting .NET Framework 4.5.2 that uses MVC. Once the project completes spinning up, we'll use the package manager to install the Twilio NuGet packages. Namely, we will install package Twilio to get the helper library for the REST API, and then we'll also install package twilio.aspnet.mvc, which provides some helper conveniences for our MVC application. Then we'll create a empty MVC5 controller that we'll name SMS controller, which is going to hold the logic for our application. Inside of the controller, we'll bring in some dependencies. We need the system.configuration namespace to access app settings, and then we'll pull in all of the namespaces for the Twilio helper library that we just installed. We'll change the class for the controller to Twilio controller, which is going to give us a helper when we talk about inbound SMS. But first, let's do outbound SMS. So we'll create an action method called sendSMS. The first thing we need in here are a couple of credentials. We need the account SID and auth token from our Twilio account. These look like this, but I've got them stored in app settings, so we'll get them from there instead, pulling in both the Twilio account SID and the Twilio auth token using the configuration manager. Next, we'll initialize the Twilio REST client by passing in the account SID and auth token that we just got out of app settings. Then we can create a message, but to create a message, we need phone numbers. So the to phone number is going to be my phone number. Phone numbers look like this, but you guessed it, I've got mine stored in app settings so that I don't have to show it to you. So we'll pull that from there. Then the from number is going to be that Twilio phone number that we just purchased from the numbers console. So we'll paste that in there. Next, we'll create a message using messageResource.create. We'll be passing in the to phone number and the from phone number, as well as the text to go into the message of the body, which is, this is the ship that made the Kessel Run in 14 parsecs? Yeah, that one. It's 12. Finally, we'll return the message SID so that we know that the message was sent. We'll run our code and head over to the browser, and once the application's running, we can go to /sms/sendsms, and we'll get a text message sent to our phone. It really is that easy to do outbound SMS in C#. Now let's talk about inbound SMS. A user sends a text message to your Twilio phone number. Twilio makes an HTTP request to your app, and your app returns some instructions in the form of something called TwiML. If the TwiML looks like this, then Twilio sends a text message back to the user's phone. Let's write the code to make that happen. We'll add a new action method to our SMS controller called receiveSMS. And inside of receiveSMS, we're going to create the response to Twilio's HTTP request using the messaging response class. We'll set the message on our response to be "the robots are coming, head for the hills." And then we'll return the TwiML representation of that response. We'll give our code a run. Problem is, it's running on localhost, so we need to use something to create an HTTP tunnel. We're going to use ngrok. There's an extension that you can find in the Visual Studio extensions that makes this really easy. You can just go to Tools, Start ngrok Tunnel, and it'll fire up a tunnel to the right port. This gives us a publicly addressable URL that we can copy and take back over to the Twilio phone numbers console. We'll paste it in where it says a message comes in webhook and add /sms/receiveSMS to the end of the URL. If I save that, I can take back out my cell phone and send a message back saying hi to our Twilio phone number, and we should get that robot's response. And there it is. That's all there is to it to handling inbound SMS with C#.